So good day and welcome again to my video of laboratory exercise number 8 entitled One Configuration and Routing System. So let's proceed immediately to the procedure. Number 1 procedure, after doing the experiment in lab 4, we will now establish a one link. Make sure that experiment 4 is completed before proceeding in this experiment. So this is my lab number 4. In configuring one connection, click CISCO 1 router and select config mode. Choose interface area 0/0/0. Configure interface serial number by designating IP address to 192.168.2.1, then press the tab key and enter the subnet mask 255.255.255 on the interface. So we will set the IP address to 192.168.2.1. So there is the subnet mask. Set clock rate to 56,000. This is the clock rate, 56,000. Enable the port status to on mode. So port status on. So this is done. Next is click on a new router and select the config mode. This is the other router. Change the display name and host name to CISCO 2. So we will change the name to CISCO 2. Configure interface serial number. For this one, it's 192.168.2.2. Subnet mask. Enable mode on. There, port status is on. Indication that the link is successful is when the serial link the red blinking light should change to green, showing that the link is active. So there is the green color there. Configuring the routing protocol, click on CISCO 1 router and select configuration tab. Then click RIP add network address 192.168.2.0. So we'll click CISCO 1 under routing. Okay. 1.1.0 and 192.168.2.0. Then click on CISCO to router and select configuration tab, then click RIP and then add the network address. So same procedure. And set default gateway to 192.1.1. The setting default gateway and the PCs enter the default gateway to 192.168.1.1. The three PCs, they have the same gateway set. Test the connectivity of the network by clicking the simulation mode. Proceed to the questions. Question number 1, what is the difference of LAN connection to WAN connection? A LAN or local area network is a group of computers and network devices connected together, usually within the same building, while a WAN or a wide area network connects several LANs and may be limited to an enterprise, a corporation, or an organization, or accessible to the public. Number 2, can we establish a communication from one point to another having same networks? My answer is no, because we need different networks in sending and receiving communication. Number 3, why do we need to configure the router? To make our work complete, we need to configure our router, because a configured router means there will be a smooth flow of communication with our network components. What can you conclude for this activity? I therefore conclude from this activity that to be able to make a connection, we need different networks, and routers play a vital role to complete the connection. So thank you, and